not faith in man, it's not faith, as this lady said, in organised religion. It's faith in Christ. He's the one who rose from the dead. And that's all we need in Jesus. We don't need priests, we don't need all these people. We just need the word of God, Jesus.
Jesus beat the grave. So again, I'll say, we don't put our hope in an ideology. We don't put our hope in a religion. We put our hope in a person, the God-man, Jesus Christ, the one who died on a cross for those of us who've done wrong. Now, just be honest with me now. Is there anyone going by in St. Helens perfect today? You perfect, girls?
Yeah.
You're perfect. I'm sure your mum thinks you're perfect. But we're not, are we? But the good news is this. There's only two types of people that get to heaven. Perfect people and forgiven people. I'm not perfect. We might have beautiful faces. But we're not perfect on the inside. We've all got skeletons in the closet. But every single one of us can be forgiven if we come to the cross where the Son of God bled and died on that cross. You know, we've all got sort of stains, okay? Have you ever seen that? Do you remember when you were at school? Do you know those whiteboard markers? Have you ever written on a whiteboard marker and you leave your pen on there, okay? And then you rub it off. And then the pen still remains, doesn't it? You know what, girls are laughing at. You know what I'm talking about, don't you? When you scrub it off, and maybe you write 2 + 2 = 4, and then you scrub it off, and you can still see the faint mark of that pen. That's kind of what it's like for us. Maybe we get drunk one night. Maybe we have a fight. Maybe we lie, or we have a big Barney, or we do something wrong we're ashamed of. It's in the past, but we can still see it in our lives. It still stains us, doesn't it? And that's what our sin does. It stains us. But the Lord Jesus Christ can cleanse that sin, can scrub that sin away completely, because his blood can wash us whiter than snow. Can I ask you a question? Have you put your trust in the Lord Jesus Christ? Here's a serious question. I don't want to upset anyone, but suppose tonight is your last night on planet Earth, and you die, and you meet God, and God says this very powerful question. He says, whatever your name is, say your name's Sarah, say your name's Claire. Claire, why should I let you into heaven? What would your answer be? You say, because I'm a good person. Well, Jesus said there's no one who's good enough to get to heaven. None of us can reach it. The only answer is through Jesus. He's the only one who can save us. Just like you'd be so stupid to jump out of a plane without a parachute. Would you do that? This girl here would jump out of a plane without a parachute. I wouldn't, I'd be too scared to do that. Just like it'd be very foolish to jump out of a plane without a parachute. You'd be very, very foolish to leave planet Earth to die without the Son of God, Jesus, on the cross, who can save you. Do you think about that today? Do you think about this God who loved you and died on that cross? Yeah? It's a great message, and it's a true message. That's why we bear the name of Christ. Because he died for our sins. Is anyone now thinking, what a load of rubbish? This man's speaking nonsense. There's no evidence for Jesus. You carry on reading your fairy tales. You carry on reading your Bible. It's all a load of rubbish. I'll give you some solid evidence for Jesus Christ. And it's straight down to your own home. What year were you born in? Would anyone like to tell me what year? The man who's there waving his hand. What year were you born in, sir? 1973, yeah. 1,973 years after who? After Jesus. BC, before Christ, AD, in the year of our Lord. Jesus Christ, he came into this world and he rose from the dead. And we measure our calendar from it. If you were born in 2000, it's 2,000 years after Jesus Christ. He shook the world up and he's still shaking people today. He can change your life. And